Hello. Is it audible now? Okay, thank you. See this. This is the way to use the if statement. If some condition followed by the colon, and if you immediately press colon, by default you will be getting the indentation of four spaces. And if you follow all the four spaces, then all the statements that are following that indentation comes under that if statement. See that? If you observe clearly, see the if number mod 2 double equals to 0, as you know, double equals to is used for comparison, whereas single equals is for assignment. Now the condition should be terminated with the colon symbol. Now there is only one statement that comes under the if statement. So if you execute these statements, you will be getting the output. And see the first line of the output, and see, enter the number. It is giving the prompt. Input function is used to take the input from the keyboard, and it is asking for enter the number. That prompt you are getting. That is the reason for input function you are passing one string parameter. That parameter is nothing but the prompt. After that, what is the number that you are entering? 10. And by default, 10 is of string type. By default, it is a string. Now what you are doing, the 10 string you are converting into integer by using the int of 10. And that integer will be converted into the number. Now number will become the integer value, 10 mod 2 equal to 0. So the condition is true. The next statement that comes under that if statement is executed, that is number is even. Now coming to the one example that uses the if statement. The purpose of this one is to still people are facing a problem with my audio, but for today I'm helpless. Why? Because my computer microphone is not working. I'm using the one earphone. I think it is creating the problem, but for the next time I try to resolve this. You please try to pay attention and listen. So the second example is the finding out the largest of three numbers by using the only if statement. Look at this. Here, what we are doing in the first statement, we are taking the input and the value we are storing into the A. This statement we have already seen in the previous example. Input is used to take input from the keyboard. By default is of string type, and that is converted into the integer, and the value is stored in A. Here we are writing this program to calculate the to find the largest of three numbers. That is the reason we are taking the three variables A, B, C, and all the three variables values we are taking into the from the keyboard, and those are converted into the integer. Now you see the statement. If A is greater than B and A greater than C. And if we have observed, if we compare this syntax with the C language syntax, two ampersand symbols are used to perform the logical AND operation in C language. But coming here, you can use A AND to perform the logic AND operation. The logic AND operation, I think you know, if the first condition is true and the second condition is true, if both are true, then only the statement will be executed. And if you observe the program syntax clearly, the if statement doesn't have any kinds of braces to specify the condition. And if statement is terminated with a colon symbol here. After that, you have, see the spacing, that is called as indentation. After I, see this, my pointer. I, if you come here, this is the location where the I is available. From here, there are four spaces are there. That means this is the only statement that comes under the if the, for this if condition. This is called as indentation of four spaces. If you are using the editor, if you are using the if statements, if you press enter, by default it will take the indentation for the editors. But for normal notepads, for the normal notepad, you have to manually give the indentation. And for the second if statement, if B is greater than A and B is greater than C, it is not required in, semicolon is not required in Python. Sometimes even if you are using also, there will not be any issue. It is not required here. And here you have to follow the indentation here exclusively for the if statement. This is another example to find the greatest of three numbers by using the simple if statement. See, this is the output that you will be getting. Here I am entering the three numbers 100, 120 and 130. And after executing the program, the output you are going to get is C is the largest. Why? Because among all these three, the C 130 is the largest one. Now, if else statement. It is similar to the if statement. Look at this. If condition followed by the colon and block of statements under that indentation. Now, if the condition fails, then it comes to the else part. Else. Here also for the else is having the colon symbol. After else, you need to follow the indentation. And suppose if you have written four statements that are part of the else statement, then all the four statements have to follow the same indentation. See the example. I want to check whether a person is eligible for vote or not. What is the minimum criteria for a person to vote? He should have age of 18. Here, how it can be done is, I am taking the input, and that input I am converting into the integer and stored in the variable age, and I am checking the condition if age is greater than or equal to 18. Here you see the syntax. If statement is having the colon symbol, after that you have the indentation. The indentation is there only for one print statement. So this print statement comes under this if condition. After that, else. If you observe, else is exactly same as if under the if. See the I here, and the same location E is also available. And if E, if else is under this P, then it is wrong according to the syntax. What are all the statements that are part of the if statement? Only those statements have to follow the indentation. And what are all the statements that are part of the else block? They have to follow the indentation. Now you might have understood, even though braces are not there, how we can write the program's if statements in Python based upon the indentation. Are you understanding? So look at this. Here I am running the program. If I am giving the input as 90, first time the condition fails. If the condition fails, it go to the 90 is greater than 18. It is condition is true. The first part will be executed. If it is executed, then there is no need to go to the else part. This is if else statement. And see the one more program. I want to check whether the number is even or odd. It is same as the previous example. We are taking one number as input and we are dividing the number by 2. Here you are using the modulus operator to know the remainder. Modulus is used to specify the remainder. If it is 0, then you can print it is even number, otherwise it is odd number. Here I am giving 10. And the output that is displayed is number is even. Next, coming to the else if statement, and this is the way the representing the else if is different when compared with the C and Java language. Else if statement in C language is represented with else space if, but in Python it is represented with elif, else if. This is the syntax of else if statement. If some condition and the statements that are part of this condition will be executed, and second, else if Yes, see this one, ELIF. ELSE is not there and space is also not there. Else if some second condition and the block of statement that are part of that, and else if third statement that is part of this. These are all the statements that are part of that. If any of the conditions are not executed, then it comes to the last else part. So this is another example. We are taking a number and we are checking the number with 10. If it is 10, then it is displaying it is equals to 10. If it fails, it comes to the second part, else if statement. If it fails, it comes to the third part. And if any of the things are not true, then it goes to the last part. See this. Here we are entering the input value as 15. 15 is not matching with the any of these three conditions. That is the reason it is going to the else part. So the output you are getting is like this. And another example, suppose based upon the marks, if you are asked to allocate the grade, marks we are taking as input, if the marks are greater than 85 and marks are less than 100 and prints, you got A grade. Else if, and you are getting the B grade. If the condition is in between these two, then it is B grade, C grade. And if it fails with any of them, then it is going to the last part. So this is another example which describes about else if statement. Now coming to the loops. What is the difference between the conditional statements, if statement and looping statements? If statements are used to execute the set of statements only once based upon this condition. If the condition is true, it will be executing that part once. If the condition fails, other part will be executed. But by using the loops, if you want to repeatedly execute some statements, then you can go with the loops. In C language, we have seen for loop, while loop, and do while loop. But here we have only two loops. One is for loop, other one is while loop. See the syntax of the for loop. For some the iterating variable, suppose if I, for I equal to 0, I less than 10, that I is called as the iterating variable here. In here you need to specify the sequence. Sequence means some set of values or some range of numbers, and those many number of times these statements will be executed. See the example. Here, I'm taking the value of I as 1. Now, we are taking the value of N as input. So, in the input, enter the number up to which you want to print the natural numbers. And here, that value equal to N. Now, for I in range, here if you have observed, range is the one more function which we are looking here. Range is function which is used to generate the numbers. It will generate the numbers from 0 to 10. Here, the lower part is inclusive and the second part is exclusive. That means the range of 0, 10 to 10 will give you the numbers from 0 to 9, excluding 10. If you want to have 10 also, what you need to do, the range you need to give from 0 to 11. See that for loop example, for I in range of 0 to 10 followed by the colon. See this, here also we are having the colon symbol, and what we are doing here also, we are following the indentation, print I comma and equal to some space. I tell you what is the purpose of and equal to space. Look at this. This is the output if you are executing these four statements. I value is initialized with 1 and the n value you are taking, and these two are not required for this example. If you see the last two statements, we are printing the numbers from 0 to 10. And if you are not using the second option in the print statement, and equal to space, by default all are displayed in the single line. If you are using this, if you are omitting the end equal to space, if you are giving only print of I, all these numbers you are going to get in a separate line. If I want to print all of them in a single line, then you have to use in the second one end equal to space. That means after the first one, you need to give the space. After the next one, you need to give the space. See another example. Here, I want to print the multiplication table of a particular number. The number that I am going to give as input, that corresponding multiplication number has to be printed. Look at this. For this, the program is like this. Whichever the number you want to display multiplication table, that number you need to take as input. That number I am taking into the variable num. Now by using the for loop, I am taking the values from 1 to 11. That means it will be printed from 1 to 10. See this, the first percentage D into percentage D equal to percentage D. The first percentage D corresponds to the number, the second one is I, the third one is corresponds to num into I. So num, suppose if I am taking the value as 5, num value, that means fifth multiplication table will be displayed. Fifth multiplication table will be displayed from 1 to 10. So first 5, first percentage is 5 into the second one is I. I will be ranging from 1 to 10. The third one is num into I, 5 into 1, 5. Next one is the num will be same 5, I value will be increased to 5 to 10 like this. Look at this. Here I am taking the input as 10. And the number that is displayed from 10 1 to 10 10. Why? Because we have iterated the for loop from 1 to 11. It is not taking the second value 11. It will be taking up to the previous value 1 to 10. So that is the reason. And why it is displaying the 10th multiplication table? Why? Because that input I am taking as 10 here. Next, nested loops. What is the meaning of nested loop? If you are writing one loop inside the another loop, that is called as a nested loop. I think you might have remembered in C language, we have practiced the matrix programs, matrix addition, matrix subtraction. The matrix is a two-dimensional array. We need to have the two loops to specify the rows and to specify the columns. So in that case, we need to have two for loops. Look at this. This is the similar kind of syntax, but if you observe clearly, the second for loop is following the indentation. By indentation, if the second statement that is part of the first part, then we have to go for the indentation. Since indentation is there, this second for loop comes under this first for loop. Look at this. The first iterating variable in that sequence and the second iterating variable in the sequence, and both are having the columns. But here you need to observe, here is the second for loop is following the indentation. That means the second for loop comes under the first. For each value of the first for loop, the second for loop will be executed for multiple times. And see this block of statements, see this one. These block of the statements will only comes under this for loop. Why? Because these are the following the indentation of this for loop. And other statements means, see this indentation, it is not following the indentation for either this for loop or this for loop. It is written exactly the location of the first F of this one. That means these are all the statements that will be executed after completing these two for loops. Look at this. Now, you observe this program clearly. I'll give you 30 seconds time. Can you guess this output of this program? Just have a look at it and try to understand what are doing in this statement, in this program. And observe here, the print statement here and print statement here. In the print statement, we can take any value of the n, if it is 3 or 5, anything, that depends upon the output. See the print statement here. The print statement, we have not passed any parameters. That means simply it will be giving the blank space. And the second case, we are printing the print statement. The first one is printed, after that and equal to something. That means the next output will be displayed immediately to the star. Yes, it's kind of pattern you are going to get. Yes, some of you are giving the outputs. Look at this. I am taking the n value. Suppose if I am taking the n value as 5. After that, I am taking the I and j values to zeros. What is the first for loop is doing? It is simply printing the some spaces. After that, the second for loop, the first for loop, first it will print one space. Look at this. For I in range of, suppose if the n value equal to 3. For I in range of 0 to 3, that means first time I value will become 0. And see this. All these statements, print statement and for loop and this print statement, are all following the indentation of the first for loop. And you see the second print statement. This print statement is following the indentation for this particular second for loop only. Yes, some of you are giving the correct answers. So for the first time I value equal to 0, first it will print the one space. After that j, 0 to 0, 0 to 1. So first time one star will be printed. Next time j value will be incremented by 1. By the time the condition will be failing, then again if the control goes to the outer for loop. Again next time I value will become 1. So this time the first for loop will become first time 0, after that it will become 1. For each time this will be printed. See the output. Here we are giving the n value equal to 5. 5 rows will be printed. And if you observe clearly, to get the asterisk symbols in a line one after the another. See here, first time you got only 1 star. Next time you are getting the 2 stars. Next time you got the 3 stars. The reason here is to get the star immediate to the previous star, you have to use the and equal to this space. If you are not giving the and equal to space, by default each and every star will be displayed in a separate line. So all these stars will be printed in a separate line if you are not giving the and equal to space option here. Did you understand the difference between this print statement and this print statement? And this print statement every time that to display the output in a separate line, and this statement to display the stars one after the another. Why? Because you are using the and equal to space. Right? Now I'll go to the another one. And see this, observe the heading clearly, using else statement with for loop. Earlier we have used the else statement only with the if statement. Do you remember? Else statement can be used with the only the if statement. Suppose if you take any programming language like the C language or Java language, if you have written else statement without using the if statement, definitely you will be getting an error. But here the else statement can also be used with the for loop without using the if statement. Look at this. Here, what we are doing in this example is, I am using the for loop, which is ranging from 0 to 5, that means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Whether 5 will be printed? No. Then you are using the else. For else, whenever you are using the else, you have to follow the colon symbol. Next, print some statement. Now, when the control comes to the else part here is, once all the statements that are in the for loop, that means if the for loop is iterated completely according to the condition, then only the else part will be executed. That means the else part will be executed only once the for loop completes its execution. Are you understanding? This else block will be executed only if the for loop completes its execution. So here it is displaying the output like this. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you have observed here, I am not using the end equal to space. That is the reason for each and every time the print value is displayed in a separate line. Now since the for loop is iterated completely, then only the loop is exhausted, then you are getting the else part block. Are you understanding? Now see the another example. It is similar to the previous example only, but look at this. Under the for loop, I am printing the value of I. Immediately I am using the break statement. So first time I value will become 0, then 0 value will be printed, then break. If you are using the break statement, what will happen? It will come out of the for loop. Now if you are in this case, if the for loop is iterated completely 4 times, no. If the for loop is not completely iterated, then it will be coming out of the else part won't be executed. Did you understand? Look at this. The difference between the previous example and this example is the else part will be executed only once the for loop is iterated completely. But here, because of the break statement, the for loop has terminated immediately after printing the value of the 0. It has not iterated completely. That is the reason this print statement after the else won't be executed, but the second print statement will be executed, this one. So the output will be like this. And after this, the statement will be printed, but here I have not specified this. The output is like this, 1 is 0, this print statement. After this, because of the break statement, this else part won't be executed, but we are going to get the last statement. The loop is broken due to the break statement came out of the loop. And here, but unfortunately in this output, this last print statement is not specified. I think you got the difference between the previous and this one. Here, I would like to conclude the else statement with the for loop is, the else part of the for loop will be executed only once if the for loop is completely iterated. In the first case, it is iterated. That is the reason we are getting the output of this statement. But here, the for loop is not iterated because of the break statement. The else part won't be printed. And if you see this, if this statement need not be printed, then what you need to do? Then if you follow the indentation for the last print statement, that means if the print statement is following the indentation and written here under the first this P, then you will be getting only this output. Okay, so this is the usage of else statement with the for loop. And I told you there are the two types of loops in Python. One is for loop, other one is while loop. And if you have observed clearly, here the for loop is used to iterate a particular number of statements some specified number of times. But if you compare the for loop in Python with the for loop in either C language or Java language, it has three parts in C or Java. First one is initialization, the second one is condition, and the third one is either increment or decrement. But if you have observed the for loop in Python, see this, the for loop here, have you specified any condition here? No. The purpose of for loop in Python is used to iterate some set of statements certain number of times only. It is not, the for loop is not used to specify as long as the condition is true, like in C or C++ or Java. So if you want to iterate the set of statements based upon some condition, in that case you cannot go with the for loop, then definitely you have to go with the while loop. Did you understand the difference between the for loop and while loop in Java language? The for loop is not checking the condition, whereas while loop will be specifying the condition. As long as this condition is true, the set of statements within the while loop will be executed. But coming to the for loop, it is not checking the condition based upon the some number of times that we are specifying in the range there, and those many number of times those statements will be executed. That's it. See the while loop here. While this expression is nothing but some condition, followed by the colon, and here it is following the indentation, and the set of statements that are part of somebody are asking, then why can't we use the if statement for condition? And I've already specified the purpose of looping statements and conditional statements. Conditional statements means either if statement, if else, or nested if, or else if later. Those are not used to repeat repeatedly execute the set of statements. Those, the condition will be executed only once. If the condition is true, the set of statements will be executed. Whereas loops, those are used to repeatedly execute the statements. Though you are checking the condition by using the if statement, but you cannot iterate it many number of times until and unless if you are keeping that if statements inside the looping statement. Now see this Python while loop, while some expression, some statements here. See this, the same thing that we have displayed in for loop, displaying of some numbers. Look at this, initialization, while loop. Here also we are not using the braces like C language, and it is terminated with colon symbol. And if you observe clearly, these two statements, print statement and increment of I, those two are following the indentation. That means these two are part of the while loop. Suppose the third statement, which I am writing one more statement, another print statement, but I am not following the indentation. That means I am writing another print statement here under W here. That means I am not giving any space. Here if I am writing the one more print statement, that print statement won't come under this while loop. The statements that are following the indentation, that means four spaces, those the statements that comes under that for loop. This is the opening brace and that is the closing brace, similar to that. Right? So we are going to get the output like this. Here, why I am getting the each and every number in a separate line? Why? Because I am not using the in the print statement end equal to space. If I am not using that, I will be getting all these things in a separate line. This is the one way of using the while loop. Here, we are executing these print statements as long as this condition is true. First time I value equal to 1, then I value will become 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Once it reaches to 10, then next time when it becomes 11, the condition fails. It comes out of the while loop. There are no statements after the while loop. That is the reason the loop will be terminated. See the another example here. Can you guess what will be the output of this particular program? Can anyone guess what would be the output? We have seen the similar kind of program by using the for loop. Yes, multiplication table will be printed. If the input value equal to 2, the 2 multiplication table will be printed depending upon the value of the number. And see this statement. Now if I am not using this int, if I am not using this int, can you tell me what will happen if this part which I am representing with which I am pointing out with mouse pointer, if int part is not there, will the program will give you the same output? Yes, it won't give. Why? Because here the number which you are taking into the variable number will be a string. We cannot perform the arithmetic operations with the strings like multiplication and all. Okay, so the output will be like this. If I am giving the number, here the use of B is not required. I have taken these examples from some website, but because of lack of time, I could not able to rectify this. Here the B is not required here. Okay. See this, this is infinite loop. What is the meaning of infinite loop? If it is keep on executing, then that is called as an infinite loop. That program won't be terminated. That is called as an infinite loop. So these are the some of the examples, as you some of you said. While of one, this means one will always gives you the true. While true means every time that will be true, but there are no statements that are makes that particular condition failed. So that is the reason. One minute, I'll be on mute. I'll be back within 1 minute. Welcome back. So we are in running out of time. I have two more statements. One is break statement and continue statement. And I'll be following with the slides a little bit faster. In the meanwhile, if you have any doubts, you please place it in the chat box. And I cannot reply by using the chat, but I can give you the answers orally. So here, a semicolon is not required. I've already told you, here in this example, semicolon is not required. So this, the same statement will be executed for many number of times. And then we see here, while variable not equal to 2, the I, we are taking the different values of I that we are displaying here, but the condition is specified with the variable. But the variable value is not changed. Every time the value 2 will be true only. So it will also keep on executing. So the as we discussed else with Python, else with the for loop, we can also use the else with the while loop also. Look at this. Here also similar to the for loop, the else part will be executed once entire while loop is completely iterated. So that is the reason here. The while loop is iterated for 5 times. That is the reason the else part is also executed. The output that you are going to get like this. And look at this. Can you guess the output of this program? Similar to the previous one only. We are displaying the values from 1 to 5. And once I value reaches to the 3, we are using the break statement. That means you'll be getting the value 1, 2, what about 3? So once the break statement is executed, what will happen? Whether the else part will be printed? No. Why? Because if the while is completely iterated, then only this statement will be printed. So by the time the I value reaches to the 3, we are using the break, so 3 won't be printed. Next, another one is break statement. I think you are aware of that. The purpose of break statement is coming out of the loop. Look at this. Here, I thought to tell you one more data structure called a list. Like range, we are getting the some set of values. The list is also used to specify some values. So like this. For loop can also be used like this. For I in list. What will happen first time? I will be taking the value of the first value in the list. 1. It is checking with the number 4. If it is matching, then it will be printed. Otherwise, next again for loop will be next value will be there in from the list. So for I in list means it is iterating through the each and every element of the list. I use it 1 first time, 1 next time, 2 next time, 3. So 1, 2, 3 it will be executed. For 4 this statement will be printed. Here the output will be getting like this. Next, see this one. Even the for loop can also be used with strings. For I in str, first time I will be pointing to the P, next time I will be pointing to Y, next time T, next time H. If I equal to 0, what you are doing? You are using the break. So the output will be like this, P, Y, T, H. Why we are getting each and every letter in a separate line? Why? Because we are using the print without using the and equal to. So this is the one more example. We are getting all these statements in a single line. Why? Because here you are using the and equal to space. It is similar to the previous example only, but this time we are using the break statement with a while loop. Can you guess the output of this program? Look at this, it is multiplication table, no doubt. So as long as we are pressing 0, 0 is for stopping the multiplication table, 1 is to continue. Here I am using the 1. We are running out of time. I need to close this presentation. That is the reason I am going a little bit faster. There are very few slides are there. I am going to forward these slides to you. No issue. See here, the previous program is, I am displaying the corresponding multiplication table. Before displaying, I am asking for the choice. If the choice equal to 0, then we are coming out of the loop. If the choice other than 0, then we are continuing. See that? First 2 will be displayed. After that, you are asking for the choice. If I am entering 1, then 3 will be displayed. Here, I am taking the value 0 so that I stop the multiplication table here. As long as you are pressing 0, the multiplication table will be continued. So that is about the break statement. Opposite to the break statement is continuous statement. The purpose of this one is to continue. If the condition is satisfied, it will continue to the previous statement. Look at this. First I value is assigned to 0, 0 not equal to 10, so condition is true, I value will be printed. Again continue. Before increasing the value of I, you are continuing. So that is the reason here you are getting the infinite loop. And here, look at this. I want to print the numbers from 1 to 10. If the value of I equal to 5, what you are doing without printing, again you are continuing. First time I equal to 1, so continue won't be executed. I value 1 will be printed. Next time 2, 3, 4. All these will be printed by skipping the continue. Once I value equal to 5, the condition is true, continue. Here this time I won't be printed, and it will go to the previous one. So these are all the things we are done with today's presentation. Today I am summarizing the things. What we have discussed is, we have seen the different kinds of environment for Python to create and execute. We have seen Python shell, we have seen the IDLE and online compiler, Jupyter Notebook and Anaconda environment. These are the different things where we can create and execute the Python programs. After that, we have seen the variable declaration. Without there is no need to use the data type for declaring the variables. And the second one is assignment. The multiple values can be assigned to the different data variables. After that, we have seen the conditional statement, if statement, if else, nested if statement. And we have seen the loops. One is for loop, while loop, and two more statements, break and continue statements. And some of you have asked me to go to the previous slide. Which slide you are expecting me to go? Break statement or infinite loop? So I'll drop you my email ID. And if you have any doubts, you can contact me through my email ID. And Yes, without using the continue statement also we can execute the statements. Which statement, which slide you want me to continue? Infinite loop. So to see this infinite loop, whenever we are specifying the condition should always be true. Any non-zero value will be represented as a true, while 1 or while 10 or while minus 10, while minus 1, everything is non-zero value which is always true. So what are all the statements by following the indentation that comes under the infinite loop? If you see this one, here we are displaying the value of I, but the condition is checked with the variable, not with the I. So we are not changing the value of I. Every time the value of I will become, variable will become 1 only. 1 not equal to 2, every time the value is the same. And somebody was asking about last slide. Is it the one? Yeah. So this is the last slide, you tell me now. See this first statement, what is the value of I here? Yeah, this is the last slide which I have shown to you. Continue statement. Yeah, this is the last slide. See this, I value equal to 0, 0 not equal to 10. So this time, 0 not equal to 10, this time what will be printed? 0 will be printed. Next time, continue. Again, what is the value of I? 0. 0 not equal to 10, the condition is true. Again, 0 will be printed. Here, infinite loop means this is not the output. The 0 will be printed infinite number of times. Okay. I have already given my email ID. Once again, I will give you. So indentation is nothing but spacing. Somebody are asking. Indentation is to specify what are all the statements that comes under that condition. And I equal to I plus 1 to go get the next value. Those two are different. I equal to I plus 1 won't be executed here. Why? Because look, observe clearly, first time I value equal to 0, 0 not equal to 10. So the condition is true. Again, which statement is print, which value will be printed? 0. Immediately after the 0 is printed, again the next statement is continue. From here, the control goes to the again while loop. Again, what is the value of I? 0 itself. Again, 0 will be printed. Next time is continue. The control won't comes to the I equal to I plus 1. I equal to I plus 1 won't be executed at all. And coming to this second example, see, observe this. And the continue statement is under the if statement, but not the print statement. Look at this. This print is part of the for loop, not if statement. See that if statement only continues following the indentation, but print is not following the indentation of if. Okay. So this print comes under this for loop. That is the reason all these numbers are printed except 5. For 5, the continue statement is executed. And thank you very much, students. And I'm very sorry for the kind of disturbance it is created to you. My audio is not so clear. I'm getting the noise. Next time when I am get back to you, I try to resolve this. Thank you very much. I'm going to share my PPT with all of you. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you. Uh, some of you are asking why Python programs take more time to execute compared to C and C++. The answer itself I told in the beginning. All other are having the compilers. What the compiler will be doing is all the statements will be compiled at once so that it will be faster. But coming to the interpreter, it will be executing statement by statement. The Python is interpreted language, not compiled language. That is the reason the Python is a little bit slower when compared with the C or C++. Now I am terminating the presentation, and there is one more faculty from CIC department. He is the in charge of all these kinds of video presentations. He is our placement officer, Girish Kumar sir. I will be sharing the PPT with Girish sir so that he will be forwarding it to all of you. And still, if you have any doubts, you can contact me through email. And sorry for the inconvenience of audio. Thank you very much for your patience listening. Thank you.